Now that we have a qualitative understanding of eccentricity, let's figure out the equations for our conic sections in polar coordinates. They'll turn out to be very simple. So our setup is this. I'm going to put the directrix to the left of the origin. The focus is at the origin. The directrix is to the left. And so if you have a point x, y, which you think of in polar coordinates as being a distance r and an angle theta, then its distance from the focus, which we called L, is just R. And its distance from the directrix, well, the directrix was at x equals negative d, so the d is the distance from the focus to the directrix. And then you have that plus x, and x is R cosine theta. So we have that L is equal to R, and d is r cosine theta plus d. And of course, you remember that the equations for all of our conic sections is that r should be e times d. Okay? So let's do the algebra. L is e times d. And we said that L was r, and d was r cosine theta plus little d. And we just expand it out. R is ER cosine theta plus ED. We put the ER cosine theta on the other side. Factor out an R. And divide by 1 minus E cosine theta. There we go. This is our equation for a conic section in polar coordinates. Now, sometimes it's convenient to give E times, E is just a constant and D is a constant, so we usually give it another name and write it as A over 1 minus E cosine theta. And in fact, this describes circles as well as other conic sections. If E is 0, then we just have R equals A, that's a circle. If E is a small number, we get an ellipse. If E is 1, we get a parabola. If E is bigger than 1, we get a hyperbola. All of these conic sections have the same form. You don't have to memorize a whole bunch of different formulas. It's one formula for all of the conic sections. Okay. So here's a picture of what's going on. So in all cases, we want R is 1 minus ED over 1 minus E cosine theta. So the way to get the biggest value of R is to have the smallest denominator, and that's when cosine theta equals 0. So you get farthest away in the distance opposite the directrix. You open off to the right. If you have an ellipse, you get this whole loop. Now, if you have a parabola, here's a parabola, E equals 1. If you have a parabola, then you cannot have theta equals 0 because you have 1 minus cosine theta in the denominator, and cosine theta can't be 1, so theta can't be 0. You get all angles except theta equals 0. You can go, if you look off at an angle of 0.00000001 degrees, you go incredibly far. The parabola curves, and the farther out you go in the parabola, the more the parabola is almost horizontal. For a hyperbola, however, you're dividing by 1 minus E cosine theta, and E is bigger than 1. You can't have cosine theta equal to 1 over E. So you've got a limited range of angles. The hyperbola, in the long run, is pointing off at some direction, and you never get inside that direction. Of course, you could try plugging in a value of theta that's smaller than that. Then you'll get cosine theta is bigger than 1 over E, and you get R equals is negative. So those values of theta with R negative actually give you the other lobe of the hyperbola. Okay? Now, we did all of this assuming that we had our directrix to the left. We could just as well take the directrix pointing in any old direction. So if you put the directrix tilted, it's the same picture as before, only, you know, this is the old picture, only now we've rotated everything by an angle theta naught. instead of getting something that opens up to the right, we get an ellipse that is diagonal, or maybe a parabola that's diagonal, or a hyperbola that's diagonal. In any case, we get this kind of curve that's opening up in the direction opposite that of the directrix. And the only thing that's different is the equation for distance. See, this angle that you have to measure the distance by, this angle isn't theta. This whole thing is theta. This angle is theta minus theta naught. So you wind up with cosine of theta minus theta naught instead of cosine of theta, and the equation just winds up looking a little bit different. So this is the most general equation for a conic section. It's not just one that's opening up to the right, it's one that's pointing in whatever direction you please, takes this form. Finally, there are some special values of theta naught that come up an awful lot. The first one is theta naught equals 90 degrees, where we rotate, we took our picture, and we rotate it by 90 degrees so that the directrix is below the axis, and the conic section is opening up above the axis. In that case, we get cosine of theta minus 90 degrees, or theta minus pi over 2. And cosine of theta minus pi over 2 is the same thing as sine of theta. So we get an equation that involves sine instead of cosine. If we had picked the directrix above the x-axis, horizontal and above, then we would have had theta equals negative pi over 2, and instead of getting sine of theta, we'd have minus sine of theta. 1 minus minus e sine theta is 1 plus e sine theta. And finally, if you put the directrix to the right, and some authors do this, I believe that Stewart does it this way, then you get theta equals pi, theta naught is pi, and cosine of theta minus pi is minus cosine theta. So wherever you put the directrix, you always wind up with ED over 1 plus or minus E times sine or cosine of theta, if it's a vertical or horizontal directrix. And if it's a slanted directrix, then you have to use 1 minus E cosine of theta minus theta naught. In any case, there's the equation when the directrix is to the right. There's the equation when the directrix is at the bottom. There's the equation when the directrix is at the top. And there's the equation when the directrix is at the left.